Hey, what is going on, guys? XpertFusion here, and today we are going to be doing the trendy thing to do right now in the Call of Duty community, which is using Tiermaker to rank all Call of Duties ever since Call of Duty 4 all the way up to Black Ops 4. So I've done a ranking video before, like 1 to 11, because there was 11 at the time when I made it. So go watch that if you would like, but I'm still going to do a video like that when Black Ops 4 is done with the flight cycle, so probably around September-ish, right before, maybe October, depending when Modern Warfare 4 comes out. A little bit before that is when I'll do like a top 12 Call of Duty games and rank all of them and kind of make in-depth video. This is going to be just kind of what people have been doing lately, which is tiering them on this sort of scale. Now, I created the scale myself because I thought it was the best scale to make for my personal opinions and preferences, because a lot of other scales have usually hot trash or garbage or bad at the bottom. Personally, I don't think any Call of Duty game is bad. I don't. I've enjoyed at least a little bit of every single one of them. So to put one at bad is just not something I can do. Not good, though, I can go with that. So how am I ranking these? Well, it is being ranked on the entire game, from the campaign to the multiplayer to the co-op, whatever co-op modes they have. The entire game. Everything. I'm not being blinded by nostalgia on this list. I'm not using any of my nostalgia to, make any difference in this list. Personal preference, though, is a factor. That is something I am taking into account, because obviously we all have different personal preferences. I might like something that you don't, and that's fine. But in terms of this list, I'm trying to keep nostalgia out of it. That's about it. But personal preference is different than nostalgia. But I'm trying to be as objective as possible when it comes to other things like the game itself and the balance behind it. And is it good? Is it a good, well-polished game? Now, how much fun I had, that's subjective. That would go under personal preferences. So, which it could also go under nostalgia to an extent, but I'm trying to keep that out of it. Because when you put nostalgia in the list, obviously you're going to like the older games better because you had more nostalgia for those older games if you're a OG Call of Duty player. And before, you start calling me some newbie who hasn't played any Call of Duty, I've been playing since 2006, I believe, with Call of Duty 3. So I'd consider myself an OG. So after seeing my list, I don't want to hear it. But we're going to go in order from Call of Duty 4 all the way up to Black Ops 4. We'll go, in order, obviously. So Call of Duty 4. The entire game, like I said. But in my opinion, campaign isn't as important as the co-op and multiplayer. So as much as, a campaign could be really good in a game, it could still be pretty low if the multiplayer is not that great. You know what I mean? So campaign, if I'm taking it into account, probably like 20% of the campaign and 80% of everything else, something like that, man. Because honestly, campaigns are great and all. I love the story behind them, but they're not replayable. You play it once, you usually never play it again. Maybe twice, that's about it. If it was really good, you'll play it a couple more times, but that's really it. You can't play with friends, you can't really progress with the older games. They've been trying to add a lot of replay value to some of the newer campaigns like Black Ops 3, which was a shit campaign, let's not be fake about it, but they added progression systems so you can actually see yourself progressing and actually work towards something rather than just playing through a story. But multiplayer and co-op is always just more replayable and, in my opinion, a better portion of the game. So I'm going to make that as a more important factor when deciding these things. So Call of Duty 4, Modern Warfare. Now this is taking into account the original as well as the remaster. They're kind of going to be combined. If it was talking about just the original, it would probably be like okay or pretty good, to be honest. But I want to put it at amazing, because Modern Warfare Remastered added so much replay value with the supply drop system. I know people don't like supply drops, but the way they added them was really good, because you could just craft the items with the parts that you earn. Now, granted, you have to get the parts from supply drops, but it's not like you can open a bunch of supply drops and not get what you want. After a certain amount of drops you open, you're guaranteed to get what you want because you get enough salvage and you can go buy something. You might get it, if you're lucky, you might get what you want a little quicker, but you're still guaranteed to eventually get what you want, which is why I enjoyed it. The campaign was good. It wasn't the greatest in the world. I think there's a lot of better campaigns out there. I'm going to put it in pretty good, honestly. The fact that it doesn't have a co-op mode, in my opinion, is what really puts it at pretty good. Like, if this had some, like, amazing sort of co-op mode, like zombies or something, it would probably be at least amazing or the best. I think also a big part of what kind of ruined this game for me, which I want to say ruined, but didn't make the game as good as the others, is the fact that it doesn't have kill streaks. When I say it always has kill streaks, it doesn't have more kill streaks than just the original three, because that gets old when you have to use UAV, the airstrike, and the chopper for the entirety of playing this game. You know, a lot of the other Call of Duty's kill streaks are one of the biggest parts of Call of Duty, in my opinion. Now, I think it's what made Call of Duty so unique and different from other games is the fact that they had a reward system for doing good. And this game, to me, just it got old when you're using the same three kill streaks the entirety of the game. So that's why it's going to be pretty good. I think the remaster made it a lot better, though. I think adding new camos, weapon kits, which were really awesome. The melee weapons, awesome. The maps were great, too. I mean, there are some great maps. Some of them were also pretty poop at the same time, but that's that. Next up, we got Call of Duty World at War. I'm going to get crucified for saying this. Absolutely crucified, but I'm putting it not good. I'm sorry. Look, let me explain. Before you say, wow, I must have not played it in its prime time. No, I played this game in 2008. Was it 2008, 2009? It came out 2008 and was, you know, 2008 November, and it was played throughout 2009. Yeah, but I played it throughout its prime. I did. I played campaign, multiplayer, zombies. I loved it back then. I had a lot of good times on it. I remember coming home and playing Nocturne Totem with my buddies in the basement. Good times, right? But when I look back at it, looking at it objectively, it's not that good. Campaign was pretty phenomenal. I'm going to be honest with you guys. It was pretty phenomenal. It had a good story behind it. It had some great characters. It really showed the true horrors of World War II, and I love that. The multiplayer was a broken mess. That thing was so broken. I mean, you had the MP40, which was overpowered. You had killstreaks that weren't really balanced to an extent. I mean, you only had the three killstreaks, obviously. But the airstrike was just kind of obnoxious, I'm going to be honest. Especially with the shaking of the map. Every 5 seconds you're on, the map's just shaking. It got kind of annoying. There's only five killstreaks to get, so that was kind of obnoxious. The perks, you use the same perks every game. There are so many perks in this game that are useless. The balance with the perks is just horrible, gotta say. The maps, I like a few of them, but a lot of them are also just really not that enjoyable to me. The really big ones, like CeeLo, it's not built for 6v6. It's not at all. If you were playing like 9v9, 10v10, it would be a lot better, but 6v6 doesn't play well on these maps. Then you go over to zombies. It was too simple. Yes, it's what started it all, but those maps are so simple, and they have no depth to them. Other than Duris. Duris has a little bit of depth to it, just a little bit. Not enough to really make me enjoy the mode that much, but if I'm going off of nostalgia, this game would be the best, because I had so much nostalgia for this game. But in total, as an experience, I don't want to go back and play it. I don't. If a remaster came out, it would be kind of cool to see the multiplayer remastered, yeah, but I don't know. And the maps that are in Zombies, they're all remade in two other Call of Duties. I can go play those same maps in Black Ops 1 and Black Ops 3. So I have really no reason to go back on World of War unless I want to play the original versions. But the original versions are not really that great because they're so glitchy and the graphics are pretty poop. And there's just so many problems, especially on Duris. Don't forget about the Juggernaut glitch where you shoot somebody with the Wonder Waffle. It takes away your Juggernaut. That's a horrible thing. So that makes Duris on World of War kind of unplayable to an extent. But yeah, that's where that's going to go. Now we'll go on to Modern Warfare 2, which I'm also going to get crucified for saying this, but it's going at pretty good. Not amazing, not the best. Let me explain why. So, when people say Modern Warfare 2 is the best, it's usually nostalgia. Let's be real here. It's usually nostalgia. And I agree. I have a lot of nostalgia for this game. I remember playing with my friends back in the day all day long, man. We played like crazy, going for nukes and everything. It was good times. But ever since, I think when Black Ops 2 came out, maybe a little bit before that, and I always go back and play the old games. I always, every year, I will go back and play every single previous Call of Duty at least once. And that's probably why I'm playing less and less of the new game as each year go on. Because as each year go on, there's more and more Call of Duties because there's more coming out, right? So I think that's why I'm playing less and less of the newer games, is because there's just so many other games as time goes on to play. Like this year, I've been just going back and playing World War II, Modern Warfare 2, Black Ops 3, Black Ops 2. There's so many to play that I get less time to play the newest one, which is, I guess, an issue if you really think about it. But obviously, I don't have to go back and play all of them. I just want to. But Modern Warfare 2 is one of the games that is a couple patches off of being the best. It's a couple patches of being away from being one of the best. The multiplayer, or the campaign, incredible. one of the best of all time, in my opinion. The Spec Ops is just, it's fun, yes, but it's not nearly as replayable or amazing or in-depth or wonderful as Zombies is. Let's be real here. Spec Ops is awesome, yes, but it's not something I would want for a co-op mode. It's not any different. It's literally just campaign missions, parts of campaign missions, without any story, and you can play with your friend. It's cool. It's a cool idea, but for a cold co-op mode, is it really that huge? Zombies is way bigger, way more enjoyable. And then you got the multiplayer, which is broken. It is, by default, it is broken. Now, it's a couple patches away from being perfect. You patch one-man army, you patch the noob tubes, you patch some of the perks like Commando, you balance some of the weapons out a little bit, you balance some of the kill streaks a little bit. I'm not a big fan of how much people camp in this, how people just play in this game. It encourages camping. The kill streaks in this game just encourage camping, which is kind of unfortunate because I always want to go back and play it, but I can never really enjoy it myself because people play it like such horrible individuals. They're just using the noob tubes, one-man army, and just sitting in the top of a building and just shooting you down, and it's like, bro, I'm just trying to play and have a good time, but you're just ruining the experience. Modern Warfare 2 could be really close to being the best, but unfortunately, it's bugged down by a broken multiplayer, basically. Call of Duty Black Ops, the original Black Ops, you're going to go to the best. That's just obvious. This is probably my third favorite Call of Duty Black Ops of all time. The campaign's phenomenal. Zombies is great. Not my favorite Zombies of all time, but it definitely took a big leap forward compared to World of War with adding Easter eggs and all sorts of fun stuff like that. That's why I love Black Ops. I think it's one of the best. The multiplayer is also incredible. Some of the best maps in Call of Duty history. Very well map design. These kill streaks are really, really fun. They're not as annoying as Modern Warfare 2's kill streaks. I mean, they're not as good as Modern Warfare 2 kill streaks, but I liked that they weren't as good because it made it so people didn't camp for them. Instead, they just played the objective, played the game, and if they got them, they got them, and they use them. I like that better. I think kill streaks are really, really good when they're score streaks. I want them to be overpowered when they're score streaks because they're score streaks, so people will actually play the objective. But when they're just kill streaks, I don't want them to be overpowered like they were in Modern Warfare 2 because then people are going to camp for them. That's the problem with Modern Warfare 2, one of the biggest problems. But yes, Call of Duty Black Ops, phenomenal. Love the game. I don't think anything will get me to hit it. Modern Warfare 3. I'm going to put this at okay. Modern Warfare 3, I think, is overrated, to be honest. A lot of people, I think Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare 3, and World of War, all three of those are overrated. Are they bad? No, I didn't say any Call of Duty is bad. The campaign in Modern Warfare 3 is one of my favorites. Might be my favorite, actually. Especially the ending. The ending was amazing, man. This campaign was just incredible from start to finish. But the rest of the game was just not good. The multiplayer felt like a step down from Modern Warfare 2. They patched a few of the major issues from Modern Warfare 2, basically. And then they just took away all the great maps from Modern Warfare 2. They took away all the great killstreaks from Modern Warfare 2. And they kind of just made it meh. You know what I mean? And The game looks like shit. I don't know what it is, but Modern Warfare 3 just has some shit graphics. It really does. Compared to Modern Warfare 2, compared to Black Ops, compared to Black Ops 2, Modern Warfare 3's graphics are poop. They really are. I mean, multiplayer at least. They look alright in campaign. I do like how they introduced the point streak system because people actually play the objective for streaks. I do enjoy that. But the streaks weren't that good, really. I mean, some of them were cool, but that's about it. Going for mobs was kind of fun. Some of the guns were cool, but a lot of the guns were repeats of Modern Warfare 2 guns, or they were just not really that unique of weapons. The maps, I hated the maps in this game, other than Dome and maybe like Arcadian or something. And Boardwalk was kind of cool, but the other maps were just so bad. I mean, there's no iconic maps in this game other than Dome and a couple, maybe one or two others, really. And the Spec Ops, Survival, it's just, like I said, Modern Warfare 2, not that exciting. Survival is literally just taking multiplayer maps and throwing bots at you, and you just fight the bots. It's not that interesting. Not at all. Next up, Black Ops 2. Not even gonna hesitate. Black Ops 2 is my favorite Call of Duty of all time. Will probably be like that for a while. I'm hoping another Call of Duty can beat it, but it hasn't yet. Black Ops 2 is just everything a Call of Duty should be. Campaign? Incredible. Multiplayer? Incredible. Zombies? Incredible. All around, it's an incredible game. I have no major complaints with this game. There's a few things here and there, which I'll explain. In terms of the multiplayer, the C4s and snipers. Those are the two things that I think need to be either nerfed or taken out. The game's also broken now. It's very glitched to hell, which is unfortunate. It's, well, not glitched. I mean, it's hacked to hell. But I don't include hacks in this list because it's not something they really can control because they don't go back to old Call of Duty and patch them. Like, when I put World of War at not good, I wasn't basing it off of the fact that it's a hacked game. That had nothing to do with it. The glitches are different. Glitches are something that they can easily fix. They can easily go in and stop them. Hacks are a little different for older games. They're not going to do that. And it's something that people only do the older games now anyways. But Black Ops 2 is hacked to an extreme now, which is unfortunate. It doesn't take away the fact that it's one of the best of all time. The score streaks are amazing. I love the fact that they have score streaks. The maps are some of the best map design maps in the entire of Call of Duty history. The guns are fun. They're really balanced. Some of the balanced, most balanced guns in the entire Call of Duty history. The Zombies has two of the best maps, Mob of the Dead and Origins. Buried is pretty good as well. The other couple are pretty bad maps, but they're not, you know, it's not enough to bug down the rest of the experience. You have all sorts of game modes and Zombies to play. You have a lot of different things to do in multiplayer. It's just a good, well-rounded experience. So Black Ops 2 comes in at the best slot. Okay. So now we have Call of Duty Ghosts. I'm going to put that at okay. Call of Duty Ghosts, I think, is underrated in many different ways. The campaign is okay. I wasn't the biggest fan of it, but it wasn't horrible either. The multiplayer was not good at launch. But when you include the DLC maps, it's incredible. I love multiplayer in this game when you include the DLC maps, because the DLC maps are so amazing, man. The Fog map, Gold Rush, a couple other ones, Ruins. You can play as such interesting people. You can get such interesting map-based score streaks. There's map-based events. There's Levolution, all this fun stuff. I enjoy it. The point streaks were actually pretty good in this game. People said they were shit, but the dog was overpowered as hell. You had the Hilo pilot. That was pretty good. The Warbird or something? Or one of the choppers was pretty good. The Battlehind, that's what it was called. It was a good game. Then you had that squads mode, which no one played, let's be real here. Extinction was okay, not amazing. So yeah, Ghost is just an okay game. I think it's underrated because people usually say it's hot trash, but I think it's better than what people make it out to be, for sure. Then we get Advanced Warfare. It's going to go or not good, and I'll explain why. So, campaign was cool. I think they had a lot of cool elements to it, but it still wasn't that interesting of a story. Zombies, first of all, wasn't even on disc. They literally just had it as DLC, and it wasn't that great. It was actually, I'm going to go on a limb and say Extra Zombies was bad. Just a bad experience for most people, for me personally as well. The multiplayer, I enjoyed more than I didn't, for sure. I think it was the best portion of the game. I think it had its ups and downs. I think the variant system was interesting. I think supply drops could have been done better. I wasn't the biggest fan of how they handled that. I do like the cosmetic stuff you can get for your character. I thought that was cool. I thought the weapon balance was trash. Yeah, I forgot about the weapon balance for a second. I was about to say weapon balance was good, but then I realized, no, it wasn't. The BAL 27 ASM-1 were way overpowered. There were some trash guns in the game that had no love at all. So yeah, the weapon balance wasn't very good. The score streaks weren't horrible. You just needed to put some of the attachments on the score streaks to make them good, which was a cool system. I like the Pick 13 creative class. I do like that a lot. The maps were okay. They played decent with the advanced movement. I wasn't a big fan of the advanced movement in this game. I liked it in Black Ops 3 and Infinite Warfare. I thought the advanced movement was very well done in those games. But in Advanced Warfare, it felt really clunky and just made for bad gameplay. Advanced Warfare is one of them I do go back and play often, though. I do enjoy playing it, but it's not that good. It's really not, as an overall experience. Then we get to Black Ops 3. You're going to the best, because Black Ops, I mean, call me a Black Ops or Treyarch fanboy as much as you want, but Treyarch's games are just the best. They are. I'm sorry. They are the best out of all of them. They are, in my opinion, at least. They're the most polished or the most well-rounded. Now, you can make an argument that Infinity Ward's getting better, which I think they are, in my opinion. I think Modern Warfare 4, they're going to make a solid game. But I don't know, man. They do better at campaigns, I'll be honest. They do better at campaigns, Infinity Ward. But in terms of multiplayer and the co-op mode, It's always Treyarch. It's always been Treyarch. Black Ops 3 has a trash campaign. I want to be honest with you guys. Trash. Hot garbage. Whatever you want to call it. It's bad. The multiplayer is phenomenal. It's phenomenal. Whether or not you like advanced movement is up to your personal preference. I was okay with it in this game because it played well. It was smooth. The maps were good. Score streaks were amazing. The gun balance was pretty good, other than the brekkie, of course. The supply drop system was bad. I'm a level with you guys. It was really bad in this game, but I was able to accept it to an extent. I was able to overlook it and still enjoy the game for what it is. And I played the living hell out of this game. One of my most played Call of Duty of all time. And it's because I just really loved it. Maybe I was really good at it. Maybe that's why. I usually like the games that I'm better at. That's just personal preference. People usually like the game they're better at. But Black Ops 3 is just... it's that game. It really is. And the zombies is pretty good as well. Actually, no, zombies is incredible. You have some of the best maps of all time. The Rise and Drop, Garag, Krovi, Shadows of Evil. Then they remade 8 maps, Zombies Chronicles, which was really cool. You have 14 total maps in this game. Yes, it wasn't perfect. Gobblegums kind of sucked. Wasn't a fan of that system. You had no really game modes that you can play like you could in Black Ops 2 and Black Ops 4, which is unfortunate. But as an overall experience, Black Ops 3 is just incredible. I think the first 3 Black Ops games are the top 3 games in Call of Duty history, Black Ops 2 being number 1, Black Ops 3 being number 2, and Black Ops 1 being number 3. That's my opinion, yes, but I think it's an opinion people should go by because it's true, man. It is true. Next up, we have Infinite Warfare. This is going to surprise people. I'm putting it at pretty good. That's going to surprise people, but hear me out. If you want to hear my full opinions on Infinite Warfare, multiplayer specifically, watch a video that I just uploaded like a day or two ago, and I talked about the game precisely. This game was the most underrated Call of Duty of all time, by far. Campaign was incredible, and Zombies was incredible. I'm just going to go on a limb here and say that. But in terms of multiplayer, I understand the argument where people can say it's not good. I understand, and I agree. Some parts of it were not that great. The maps, not very good. The overall uniqueness of it, it didn't really feel unique at all compared to other games. Didn't really feel like it was innovating in any major way. But as an overall experience, it's very smooth. The variant system was really good. The supply drop system was really good. You got DLC guns for free, basically. The rig system specialists were very well balanced compared to previous Call of Duty titles and as well as Black Ops 4. It just was lacking good maps. But then when you look at Campaign and Zombies, Zombies isn't so good in this game. Spaceland, Rave, Shaolin, 3 amazing maps. Wasn't the biggest fan of the other two, but those 3 maps, incredible. Such unique locations with awesome music, awesome themes, and all that great stuff. The campaign, such a good story. I mean, yes, I wasn't the biggest fan of the space theme. I would rather it be, you know, more grounded, but it was still a really good, solid game for other reasons. Infinite Warfare, it's too underrated. Very underrated. World War II, amazing. I think World War II is also very underrated. People just like to shit on this game because of how the launch was. The launch wasn't very good. They had a lot of issues at launch, but they were patched pretty quickly, and it ended up being a very well-rounded game by, like, April of 2018. It was then very well received by the community who were still playing it, and people who put World War II or Infinite Warfare or Ghost... if you put any of those 3 Call of Duties at trash tier or very low on your list, chances are you stopped playing the game after the first couple months because all 3 of those games got very good over time. Very good. Advanced Warfare, I think, was one of them that actually got bad over time. I think Advanced Warfare was one of my favorites at launch, and as time went on, I started not liking it that much. But World War II, Infinite Warfare, and Ghosts were all 3 games that got way better over time. And I think World War II is one of the best examples of that. The campaign's pretty good. The zombies, I had a great time in Zombies, I'm gonna be honest. A lot of people don't like it. I think it's good. And last but not least, we got Black Ops 4. Black Ops 4 is interesting because Black Ops 4, it's got its ups and downs. I think it was one of the most disappointing games because I was expecting a lot more from it. But just because it was disappointing doesn't make it bad. You know what I mean? Just because I had higher expectations than what should have been made does not make it a bad game. I'm going to put that amazing because, yes, it doesn't have a campaign, which I didn't really care that much because we had enough campaigns. We can take a year off from a campaign. The multiplayer is the worst part about this game, for sure. I think the other two modes are much better, but the multiplayer is still really well balanced. It's very tactical. It's very innovative with the healing system. The specialists, I can do without, but you have the bare bones mosh pit, so if you don't like specialists, you have a whole game mode for that. The maps aren't the best, but they're not the worst either. They're really just average, in my opinion. The guns are fine. I think the lack of content is kind of an issue in multiplayer. There's no lack of content in the other two modes, let's be real here. But in multiplayer, yes, you are lacking some weapons, some other stuff to do. There's really no weekly or daily challenges or contracts, which there should be. The supply drop system isn't horrible. I forgot to mention that in World War II. The supply drop system is really good in World War II. Black Ops 4, it's not horrible. It's just not the best system. I think it could be a lot better with a few changes here and there. Like, stop bundling items into big bundles. Just make us so we can buy stuff separately. Make it easier for us. Let me go over to zombies. Zombies is hit or miss for most people. I like it more than I don't. I think they're doing better now. I think being able to accept that zombies is different now makes it more enjoyable. You just have to accept that things have changed and you could actually enjoy it. Now, I think they could still fix the HUD. They can still fix a couple other problems. But after a few fixes, I think it could be really incredible. The maps are pretty good so far. Nine, Ancient Evil are some of the best maps of all time, in my opinion. And that itself, with the zombies multiplayer, it would probably be, like, pretty good or okay. If you're talking just multiplayer, it'd be okay. If you're talking the multiplayer and zombies, it'd be pretty good. But when you include Battle Royale, it goes to amazing. The Blackout mode is some of the most fun I've had in Call of Duty in a long time. Battle Royale, I was, you know, interested how it would fit in Call of Duty. It fits well. It really does. If you don't like Battle Royale, that's fine. But try to be a little unbiased and just realize the fact that even if you don't like Battle Royale, you have to admit this is some fun-ass shit. It is one of the best Battle Royale modes I've ever played. My opinion, my favorite. I like it better than Fortnite. I like it better than Apex Legends. It's just more tactical, it's more grounded, it feels more like you're actually fighting in a big arena. It's not like you're building random shit. I mean, yeah, it's what Fortnite went for, it's whatever. But it feels more grounded, more than PUBG does, honestly, which I know a lot of people disagree with me on that, but it does feel more grounded than that. Even with the zombies running around, it still feels more grounded than PUBG. I think it's just because it's more smooth. I think that's kind of why PUBG is very, very clunky. Okay, so that's a solid list. I'm going to be honest. I know people are going to disagree with me. I'm hoping Modern Warfare 4 will get into the best. But if I'm being honest with you guys, if it doesn't have zombies, I don't think it will be in the best. Because zombies is just such a fun thing that even if the multiplayer campaign and whatever the co-op they go for is really, really good, without zombies, I just don't know if it can go in the best. Honestly, if I'm going to predict right now where Modern Warfare 4 is going to go, I think it's going to go in the amazing category. I think that's where it's going to go. Yeah, that sounds about right. I want to put Modern Warfare 2 in amazing, but at the same time, the problems just don't give enough leeway. Or maybe even COD 4 with Modern Warfare Remastered, it kind of deserves an amazing spot. I don't know. Yeah, no. I'll leave it at this. This is a solid list. I don't think any game is bad, like I said. But those top 5 there, the best and the amazing, are just the best of the best. It's just how it is. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.